Hello and welcome back to Creative Cat. After sharing mother and baby sculpture, I got lots of requests for sharing some more sculptures. So today I'm going to share with you this dancing girl, of course with different materials and different techniques. You can download drawing to use it as stencil for this from my blog. I have recently added language change options, so now you can read all the tutorials in your own language. You will find Amazon links for all materials I use in description box below. So please keep commenting, keep supporting, and don't forget to subscribe. Let's start. First, I'll draw my design. You can download it from my blog www.creativecatcraft.com. Cut out the design and using it as a stencil, make two cutouts of cardboard. I will need two more pieces of this shape. Let's make support with a thick piece of metal wire. I'm using this old hanger. I want to make really strong support for this. As you can see, it's going to stand on only one pointy end. Let's stick all cardboard pieces together with our wire support. Here goes the support. Now I'll make these edges a little smoother. You can also use sandpaper for this. For base, I'm using 5 pieces of cardboard. I'll make a half slit in two of them. Stick them together. Fix the wire support in the slit. Now stick remaining 3 pieces. I mixed glue and water in same quantity. You can use any normal paper, even a newspaper. I'm not taking tissue paper as I want something more strong. Cover the edges first as they are open, and then cover the entire figure. Give one or more layers. This is tissue paper. I'm soaking 2 pieces of tissue paper in 1/2 teaspoon of glue. mix it properly. You can make all body features which you want to highlight with this. Let it dry. You can sand it and directly paint over this, or if you want to make it more strong, then give it couple of layers of POP mixed in glue, just like I will show you now. So this is 2 tablespoons of POP, 2 tablespoons of glue and 1 teaspoon of water. Make a smooth paste and cover the figure with it. Give at least 2 coats. Let it dry and smoothen it using sandpaper. I have painted it golden. You can keep it as it is if you want to, but I'm going to give it patina look. You will get ready-made patina paste to give that texture, but here I'm giving that look using just paints. So I'm mixing these paints. Patina is natural tarnish that forms on the surface of brass and other metals because of aging. Many people find that look appealing. You can take out excess paint using a towel. And it is ready. This is after a layer of varnish. This is optional. If you love this video, please hit like, share it with your family and friends, comment what you like about it, and don't forget to subscribe. Bye-bye.